R.I.P. Vikendi. Rest in peace to a real one, or at least that's what the rumor is right now. Welcome everybody back to a brand new video, and today we're going to be discussing what is rumored to arguably be one of the most controversial changes coming to PUBG, the removal of Vikendi in favor of the brand new map, and a lot of other features that are going to be added within this update that we didn't cover in yesterday's video. If you guys haven't watched that about the new map, I recommend you go watch that one first before checking this one out. But assuming everyone's caught up to speed and you watched yesterday's video, then we can go ahead and discuss this. Now, if you guys do end up enjoying today's video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Even though the news in the video may not be what you necessarily want to hear, I'm just the messenger, so I would really appreciate if you could still give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you are brand new to the channel. We are getting really close to 300,000 subscribers. We're getting closer every single day, so thank you all so much. And of course, guys, I'm streaming on my Twitch channel every single day. That will be linked in the description if you want to come watch the streams and hang out with us. It's a really good time. But anyways, guys, let's talk about the removal of Vikendi. This came as a surprise to me. Now, this is just a rumor at the moment, but we do have good reason to believe that this is true. Now, let's assume that for the sake of the video, Vikendi is getting removed for some reason, but let's also assume that it's not being removed forever. It's not being, like, deleted from the game, but it's being repurposed in another way. So let's go off those two assumptions. What is the reason for this? Now, to fully understand why they may be making this decision, we need to go back to the brand new map called Karakin. Of course, this was the brand new map that we talked about in yesterday's video. We didn't speak about it in much detail, but we did go over all the new images. I'm going to put those up on screen for you guys to check out as well. Now, basically, this is the brand new map coming in with Season 6, along with tons and tons of other new features. But basically, we've had the discussion before that the addition of brand new maps is going to be the number one thing that affects and hurts matchmaking. The biggest deterrent that doesn't allow PUBG to add new maps as much as and frequently as they like to is because adding new maps is just going to hurt the current matchmaking system, making it so that the player base is so thin that nobody is ever going to be able to get in a game. Now, this new Karakin map is interesting because it's a 2x2, which is very, very small. Like, people think Sanok is crowded. Just wait until you play this map. It didn't even seem to me like you could fit 100 players on this map. I could be totally wrong, but I didn't even think this was going to be for BR, more or less like a TDM mode or some kind of other thing they're trying. If this map is going to be for 100 player BR mode, then this is going to be very, very hectic. But that being said, that's interesting how they feel the need to remove a BR map if they're going to add something in that maybe isn't BR. But again, for the sake of this discussion, let's say that the Karakin map is in fact for Battle Royale. Let's say it's a 2x2 and is going to have 100 players, replacing Vikendi in the rotation. Now, the question is this the right choice to make? We can have a really interesting discussion about this because I know for a lot of players in the community, this is their least favorite map. You know, they could care less about it. Personally, it's not my least favorite map of all time. I would still rather play this than Sanok, but it doesn't surpass Erangel or Miramar, I don't think, for me. There's times where I'm in the mood for Vikendi, but it's never like, I don't think it's objectively the best design map, but I still feel as if it has a place in the heart of PUBG. If they were going to remove a map, I would assume that it would have to have been Sanok, because think about it, that's the only map that hasn't had an actual big physical terrain change out of all the maps. When you think about it, we have Erangel Remastered, which of course got the biggest overhaul. Miramar got a refresh with some new stuff added, and even Vikendi got, you guys remember, the overhaul to its terrain. Nothing crazy, but at least it was a modification. Sanok has really not seen any of that, and it's the most, like, outdated map there is. So if they were going to remove anything out of the queue, one would assume that it has to be Sanok. Otherwise, why would they even bother spending the time they did last season repairing Vikendi and balancing its terrain better in order to just remove it in the next season? And this is where I think the meat of this discussion happens. Going under the assumption that Vikendi is indeed getting removed, the question then becomes, for how long? Is it gone forever? And maybe is just this a temporary thing? First thing I saw when I woke up this morning and got on Twitter was an outcry of people being upset Vikendi was getting removed, which I kind of find funny because it felt like before this was a thing, everyone was okay with Vikendi getting removed, or like everyone just has no problem trashing on this map. I understand why people are upset about this, but I don't think if we put the pieces together that Vikendi, if it is getting removed, it's not going to be gone forever, and here's why. First of all, just logically speaking, that would be probably the dumbest thing they could do to themselves, removing just an absolute absolutely massive piece of content from this game that they probably spent, I would say, maybe years on. But also, more concretely, we can look at the map exclusive weapon, the MP5. Now, a lot is telling about this weapon, and if we look at the leaked Season 6 skins, you can see that there is an MP5 skin that we have never seen before that is apparently going to be added to the game. So let's go ahead and break that down. If we're getting an MP5 skin that is exclusive to Vikendi, but Vikendi's getting removed, there's a couple of options. Either the MP5 is going to be added to all the other maps, including the brand new one, and that's where you're going to be able to earn it, or Vikendi is getting temporarily removed, or maybe it's in a special playlist that just isn't available to us at the moment. Perhaps they're going to rotate seasonally some of the maps, like maybe Miramar will get removed for a little bit when a new map comes out, or they're going to substitute Sanok. I'm not sure yet. It's a little bit too far away to speculate that at the moment, but I think if we look at the MP5 and just kind of use common sense, they're not going to remove Vikendi forever. It's not just going to be deleted from the game. It could be temporarily removed. I think that is a possibility. So if you want to enjoy Vikendi, if this is your favorite map, I recommend now is the time to start playing it. So if the brand new 2x2 Karakin map is in fact replacing Vikendi in the queue, that means we still have four maps. Matchmaking should be roughly the same, or maybe even a little bit better, because I reckon if it's only this small of a map, the matches have got to go pretty quick, so this might actually end up helping queue times, I'm not really sure. Perhaps they're just removing Vikendi at the time of the launch of this, and then maybe they're going to add it back. Maybe they just want people playing the new map and then testing that out more than anything, and not really spend time focusing on the other maps. It's hard to say. So now that you kind of understand why they may be removing Vikendi, and I want to stress may, because again, this is still a rumor, but if it is likely to happen, this is why I think it is, but it makes sense, but I would rather them remove Sanok, if anything. And again, this is my personal opinion, and you guys can let me know in the comment section which map you would like them to remove if they had to pick one. Vikendi, I thought would be maybe up on that list, but again, I would have to pick Sanok, especially considering that is the smallest map to date. It's also not really got any major overhauls for us to enjoy, and it's kind of outdated at the moment. It's just my least favorite designed map, and so I would be completely okay with them getting rid of that one temporarily in terms of letting us play Karakin for a little bit, but maybe like revamping Sanok and then bringing that back at a later date. I don't know. Maybe that's what they're doing with Vikendi. Also, interestingly, coming in this update, motor gliders are being added to public matches. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is probably the first real feature from PUBG Labs that is going to see the light of day in PUBG matches. Now, there is a fundamental change that you're not going to be used to compared to PUBG Labs. Motor gliders will spawn, but they're going to be spawned in random locations with a small percentage chance, sort of like how we talked about in the video how to balance it. But the kicker here is that every single motor glider is going to spawn with empty fuel, so you have to loot a gas can before you can even fly one. This makes a lot of sense, because now you can't just land and then fly them right off the bat. You're going to have to loot first. You're even going to have to find a gas can and have enough time to fuel it up and start it up. So it's going to be quite the process getting this motor glider in the air. Hopefully it's going to provide some balance to it, but that is only going to be featured on Erangel and Miramar. The motor glider will not be found on Sanok. It won't be found on Karakin, and it certainly won't be found on Vikendi, which is interesting. Now, if they're taking Vikendi back, removing it from the queue, and then maybe going over it one more time, another coat of polish to make it better and redesign it, similar to what they did flattening the mountain, then that's cool. Maybe if they want to remaster the whole thing, I'm not going to complain. That seems very unlikely. I think probably one of the most common answers would be, this is just being temporarily moved in order to make place for Karakin, but we're not changing anything about Vikendi. It's just going to be yoinked out of the playlist for a bit, and that's kind of disappointing, because again, I would like to keep this map in the game, at least for the people who like to play it. And again, Sanok, I know that's some people's favorite map, but just not mine personally. It's a hard choice no matter which way you cut it. I don't think there's an easy answer here that's going to satisfy everybody. We want a new map, but we also don't want worse matchmaking, and so you really can't have one without the other, so we have to make some kind of sacrifice here. But when we look at the evidence, and especially the MP5 thing, this makes me excited to potentially see this weapon on more maps. I would absolutely love that. What do you guys think about that detail in particular? Because that's very telling. Either the MP5 is just going to be featured on the brand new map, and then it's going to be moved over from Vikendi, or we may see the MP5 on something like Erangel or even Miramar. The possibilities are absolutely endless, but I can almost 100% guarantee say that Vikendi is not getting removed from the game forever. It may just be a temporary thing, or it may be, you know, sanctioned off to a certain playlist at a later date. The brand new patch should be coming around to the test server within the next couple of days, so all of you who have all not downloaded the test server, I recommend you go get that back now, because it's going to be available very, very shortly. And then, of course, after a couple days of that, it's going to be added to live server. So this patch is getting ready to hit the game. I would prepare for this new map, and also I would go and play Vikendi if this truly is the experience that you want to have on PUBG, because it may not be around for much longer, but I don't think it's going to be gone forever. Also, one other key thing I forgot to mention, we have the prospect of bots coming to the game at some point to maybe fill in the empty queues. They're not going to take priority over real players in public games, don't worry about that, but for maybe some of these deader queues, bots are going to be the only option for you to play that content. So maybe if we have 5 maps in the game, some of the dead ones, like perhaps Vikendi, can only be played with bots unless there is enough players who are queuing up at the time. So maybe they're using Vikendi to test their bots. There really is a lot of options here, but I wanted just to turn this into a discussion. So let me know in the comment section, guys, do you think removing Vikendi in place of the new Karakin map is a good idea? Do you think that this removal is going to hurt the game? Do you not mind very much? Or are you happy about the change? Because one positive thing, no matter which way you look at it, whether you like Vikendi or not, this will help matchmaking queue times. Like, that's just simply a fact. If it's gone temporarily, I don't mind taking a small break off Vikendi, and I just want to know what you guys think about it. So let me know your opinions in the comment section down below. I just wanted to provide you guys this information. This is what's going around right now, and this is what I think about it. So we'll have to wait a couple days to really see what's going on, but let me know your opinions down below in the comments, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you are brand new around here, and also go check out my Twitch, link is in the description. But have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you all on the next live stream or the next video. Take it easy, guys, and peace out.